Hi there. Another important component of themes will be introduced to you through today's video. Let's explore how to work with theme colors to create your own consistent and engaging e-learning courses with ActivePresenter. Four main stages will be walked respectively. Overview, apply and manage theme colors, create new theme colors, and edit theme colors. First of all, access the Design tab and click Colors. Here, the theme color gallery includes three main sections as can be seen. The custom contains theme colors you've created. Meanwhile, the built-in has preset theme colors which ActivePresenter offers you. Finally, the other one lets you create and reset theme colors. Each set of theme colors is a combination of different hues. The currently applied theme colors are highlighted with a gray outline. You can hover the mouse over each color scheme to preview what they'd look like if applied to the current slide. To apply theme colors, just click any set you want. This way, ActivePresenter applied the new theme colors to all slides that share the same slide masters as the selected one. As you can see, just the first three slides have the same theme colors. If you want to know more about using slide masters in ActivePresenter, click the video on the screen. What's more, right-click any theme colors to see additional options. Apply to matching slides works the same way as when you click a set of theme colors. In order to apply the theme colors to currently selected slides only, pick this option. Then, you can reset if you're not satisfied with the change. This one allows applying theme colors to all slides in your project, even if they're in different slide masters. Let's see how it works. Next, ActivePresenter provides you two more options when you right-click any custom theme colors. These are Edit and Delete. This brings you to the Theme Color Editor, where you can edit the currently selected theme colors. We'll learn about that in detail in the next parts. If you no longer need any custom theme colors, just click here to remove it. Open the Theme Colors gallery, and select Create New Theme Colors to create your own set of theme colors. Here, you're free to customize your palette. This part shows 12 current hues and theme. The text, background items make text easily readable when applied to backgrounds. Thus, make sure you choose text colors that contrast well against background colors. Accent 1 is the default fill hue for shapes, icons, buttons, checkmarks in checkboxes, and dots in radio buttons. Meanwhile, Accent 2, 3, 4, 5 are the colors used for correct, incorrect, incomplete, and timeout messages, in turn. Accent 6, 7, 8 are used for other specific purposes. The sample section gives you a preview of changes, and the name box displays the name of your custom theme colors. To modify hues, click any item, then pick one color. Besides, you can choose more colors to pick exactly the hue you want, or use the eyedropper option to select any available hue on your screen. In case you wish to restore the original theme color, click Reset. When you're done, enter a name for your new theme colors and save it. Now, the new set of theme colors has been added to the custom section and can be used for later projects. The Edit Theme Colors feature is just available for custom theme colors. So, right-click your desired one and select Edit. In the pop-up dialog, perform the same steps as when you create a new set of theme colors. Hope that this video gives you the basics of working with theme colors in ActivePresenter. Bye for now.